Alright guys, we're on a good one today. I haven't been here since last year and we're tidying up at the bottom of the garden, so I'm going to flip you round and show you what we've got. Okay, so I'm just going to follow Steve down. It's quite a long garden, big garden. The house is from the 1820s. I won't show you it, but we'll just go down the bottom bit and I'll show you what bits we're going to be clearing up today. Do you mind being on camera, on video? This is Zach. He's doing a crazy paving par. We're just working behind him. That's all right. So we're going to trim this bush, and we're going to clear up this area. So you can see all the debris that's been left in the path and on the borders. Bit of a dying plant there. The pond does look like it's got a leak in it. Zach said he'd filled it up yesterday. And then just a bit overgrown. And I wasn't going to record here, but I decided to after all. So I'll show you the bit that I've started on. So we've got Steve clearing this corner. It was full of this stuff, but he's cleared this patch for the paving. And as we go, I'll show you from this angle. So if we go down the pathway, I've just trimmed the hedges back from the path. And under here, under all the debris, there is an old Victorian border that we'll show you. That's very common in a lot of the gardens around here. So we're looking to... Oh, and then it goes to brick just there. So we're going to retrieve the border, give it a bit of a tidy up around here, and I'm going to do that hedge over there as well. So I'll set you up on the tripod, check it out.
Sorry if that's a bit annoying.
So we've got all of this area to clear. It's a huge area around the pond, but it's all dead and it all needs cutting down. So I'm going to see what I can pull out and just put back to the path. But I've chopped this hedge back from the path, so you can now walk up and down it quite easily. Give that a trim. There's a rhododendron under this. I'll explain what we've got in this bed. It's mainly peonies over there that have obviously finished flowering. And then just at the front here, we've got some poppies that are, you know, long gone. So I'm just pulling them out. They'd have reseeded by now. And they've got loads of seed heads that I can shake on the floor as well. So just tidying up this edge bit really. Continuing to clear along this edge. So we're finding the edge of the path around the pond. Thank you. So I'm going to focus on this left-hand side border. Now I've done around the initial edge on the pond. I was trying to think of the most efficient way to really clear it, but if I use the strimmer, it would destroy all the vegetation that's there already. And if I show you what's there already, it is kind of worth keeping, you can see, but it's got so much dead material in it and going over the edge, it's not the easiest stuff to pull out. But I think what's going to be the best thing to do is going to be to pull it out, start from the back of the bed, some of that horrible grass that, you know, we don't like, that just seeds itself. Start at the back of the bed, work forward, and then clear the edge, and we'll end up with a load more debris on the path we can clear up. So I think that's going to be the plan. Well, we'll see what Steve's been doing on the other side as well. Take you for a walk around when we're done. That's pretty good, so we'll just keep moving up and see what we can do to neaten up these borders. Okay, looking pretty clear, pretty nice. You can see the edge. Making piles in the path to clean up later. Try the next bit. Okay, so another section. Hands are starting to hurt a bit. I haven't got the best gloves on. Well, they're not so bad, but it's not the easiest of work pulling this stuff out, and there are the odd bit of holly. All right, guys, so we're packing down. I'll show you the final result. We've shown the customer around, she's happy. So we've cleared this side and we can see all the edging. And in here as well, just cleared out the round the side of the pond. And around here, remember all the dead bushes going up there and around here. And then up there and along. We'll see Steve's stuff in a minute, but that's the hedge. So cut it away from the path. And you can see the water coming out of the pond. There's a bit of a leak in there. Then we come back round the pond. So this is round a big circle and up here. So we hedge cut back, cleared the pathway. And where Zach's just brushing up there, we cleared some vegetation from there, some pretty deep roots. We think there's a path under there, an old one. And just cleared through this border here, looking nice and clear. Nice bench to put all the gear on as well. And cleared all along this side, this border, rescuing this rhododendron from hops. It was a hops plant. And back around. So the entire sort of pond area, and that's the pond, it goes all the way up to there. And we'll have a look at Zach's pa. He's been working away while we've been working. And there it is. So he's put down some old slabs that he's broken up, some of these old concrete slabs he's probably found at the bottom of the garden. Took some stones from the path just below us and laid a very nice crazy paving path. And that's going to keep the weeds down because it was just dirt before, as you can see further down at the bottom of the garden. You happy with the path?
Yeah.
Looks good.
Safe for weeds, really.
Yep. Okay.
That bottom path now, I've got to try and do something.
That bottom bit, yeah, your work continues. Alright guys, so that's it for another day. We'll see if we can get back to this garden. But stay tuned, over and out.